Hey, Bill, it's Niles talking. I would like to thank Professor MGTOW for posting about this story. So this is from the New York Post. Amazon tests Whole Foods payment system that uses hands as ID. Forget the titanium Apple card. Amazon's latest payments method uses flesh and blood. The e-tailing giant engineers are quietly testing scanners that can identify an individual human hand as a way to ring up a store purchase with the goal of rolling them out as its Whole Foods supermarket chain in the coming months, the Post has learned. Employees at Amazon's New York offices are serving as guinea pigs for the biometric technology, using it at a handful of vending machines to buy such items as sodas, chips, granola bars, and phone chargers. According to sources briefed on the plans, the high-tech sensors are different from fingerprint scanners found on devices like the iPhone and don't require users to physically touch their hands to the scanning surface. Instead, they use computer vision and depth geometry to process and identify the shape and size of each hand they can scan. They scan before charging a credit card on file. The system, codenamed Orville, will allow... They should just call it Orwell. Oh, you know, Orwellian, 1984. This is, it makes him... look like primitive. Anyway, we'll allow customers with Amazon Prime accounts to scan their hands at the store and link them to their credit or debit card. It's accurate to within 1/10,000 for 1%, but Amazon engineers are scrambling to prove it to 1,000,000 for 1% ahead of its launch, the source said. Amazon hopes to introduce the tech to a handful of its Whole Foods stores by the beginning of next year and to eventually expand the superfast checkout to all U.S. locations. The pace of the rollout will depend upon how quickly the Whole Foods is able to install and train employees on how to use it, source said. We don't comment on rumors or speculation, Amazon spokesman said. While a regular car transaction typically takes between 3 and 4 seconds, Amazon's new technology can process the charge in less than 300 milliseconds, a person familiar with the project said. Retailers have always been interested in faster checkout, Majid Maksad, founder and CEO of Status Money, a personal finance, told the Post. You only have to walk into Whole Foods to see the massive lines of people waiting to check out. It's a massive friction point. If successful, the technology could also help encourage customers to spend more than when they visit the Whole Foods, he said. People just spend more money when they don't have to experience of touching something tangible like money, Maksad said. The utility of money becomes more ephemeral, which is why I always say spend with money, because you'll save money overall. Amazon's budding chain of Go convenience stores launched last year. Customers use a phone app to check in at a turnstile. They can fill their bags and carry them out without ever passing a register, thanks to computer vision and an array of sensors all over the store. With the new hand-based tech, shoppers won't even have to bring their phones. Nevertheless, experts say it's unclear whether customers will be enthusiastic about scanning their hands at Whole Foods. The brainwashed masses will follow like they always do. Stephanie Hare, an independent researcher who specializes in technology ethics, noted that countries with robust surveillance programs like China already use biometric checkouts in some stores, and noted that Amazon appears to have made a decision to not use facial recognition. Well, that's great. A country like China, which is a brutal surveillance state, trying to become like that, that's all we need. I think they probably made a judgment call that Americans are probably not going to want to pay with their face, but they'll be fine to pay with their fingerprint or their hand, she says. That feels less like a mugshot. Customers should avoid giving up their biometric data, Hare says, pointing out that if a company gets hacked, it could take 6 or more years for consumers to unwind the data theft. Why would you give them that data? People don't understand the risk and they're oversold the benefits. She said, we have a couple of nation states that are really, really good at stealing data right now. All right, so please comment, rate, share, and subscribe. I'll leave this in the description so you could read it. If you'd like to support this channel, you might go fund me there as well. If you'd like to follow me on Instagram, I'll leave that there as well. Peace.